Hello guys, Fax here. I'm gonna show you in my first voice tutorial for Cubik how to create from scratch an iron sword in 8-bit retro look. So let's go! First, you can see here two sprites of the same sword. The difference between the two is the orientation. In vanilla Minecraft, the swords and all tools are designed to be diagonal. In-game, it results in a pretty pixelated 3D model. Let's see the difference thanks to Cubik. Launch Cubik PRO. The current version of Cubik PRO is 0.91 and contains all we need to create 3D models for blocks and items. Okay, optimize your workspace with the window menu. We are ready to import our first PNG, the diagonal sword. Click on File and select Import. Choose the PNG format and then browse to your PNG texture. We are creating a new item, so it's better to import the PNG texture vertically. If your texture is not oriented as you want it to, you can flip it vertically or horizontally without the need to edit once again your picture. You can also set the resolution. By default, the selected resolution is the native one of the picture. Here, it's 32 by 32. You can convert it easily to lower resolutions. Well, we stay in 32 for this tutorial. If you would like to get an extruded texture as thick as a wall block, for example, just enter 16 in the thickness field. For an item, we keep a thickness of 1, which is the default value in vanilla Minecraft. Click Proceed, and you don't have to wait a lot. Your PNG is imported and extruded. We have the shape, but we need to import the texture. Go to the Material Manager and double-click on the texture label to load your texture image. Well, already looks like a finished model, but don't stop here. We need two more things. First, our model needs to be optimized. Many faces are invisible, but still present in the model. Second, our model needs to be positioned and scaled in hands, in first person, in GUI, on floor, and in item frames. To optimize the model, click on the Optim button. In our case, and in most cases, Cubik is smart enough to optimize correctly the model by deleting all unseen faces. A pop-up is displayed to summarize the optimization. Here, we have 15 faces that have been deleted. Click OK, and the optimization is done. Now, the fun part. We'll position and scale our model to let it be displayed correctly in-game. Cubik has various edit modes to ease the process. Click on Views, select Edit Modes, and click In Hand. That dialog allows us to control everything we need to make our item look like exactly what we want it to be in the 6 different cases. In Hand is how the item looks like in third-person view. On Head is how the item like if it's put in the head slot in inventory. On Floor is how the item looks like when dropped on ground. On Wall is when the item is put in an item frame, but I think it will probably be used for other things in Minecraft for the future. Then, first person is first person view. And finally, GUI is what the item looks like in your inventory. So, let's start with in-hand. Turn the camera to have a good view of your item. We could play with all full sliders like that. But in our case, we will use a preset. Cubik is shipped with various presets. You can make your own presets and share them online, in the Cubik Forum, for example. Click on the combo box and select Vanilla item. Our item looks exactly like a default item generated in Minecraft, but our item is a 3D model, which can be modified and get many more details. I think the default position and scale for a sword is a bit too small, so set the size to 1.2, push the sword upward to make the handle fit in right hand, and set the Z to -4.5 and Y to 1.4. Great. That's all for the in edit mode. Be sure to check the option to tell Cubik that our edit mode should be exported and go to the on head edit mode. By default, we can't put swords on head, but with commands, we can. So I think that would be fun to make our sword be displayed correctly if it's put on head. Our model is smaller by default when on head, so set its size to 1.7. I think it's okay. Then play a bit with the sliders to make the sword look like planted in the head. Well, I set Y to minus 90 and Z to minus 60. Z minus 4. Cool! That guy didn't have any chance and received that sword right in the face. That's okay for the on-head edit mode. We continue. Check the option and move on the floor edit mode. Here, we'll just make the sword bigger. 1.5 seems okay. Check the option and go to on-wall edit mode. The gray square is the surface of the block behind the item frame. The red square is the available space in the item frame. We can see that the sword looks quite tiny, so set its size to something around 2.5. Check the option and go to first person. Positioning and scaling the model in first person view is probably the most tricky, but in our case, we just need to use a preset. Click on the combo box and select Vanilla item. The sword is now displayed exactly like any other tool in-game. Check the option and go to GUI. If you want your model to look like flat in the GUI, use the preset front and that's done. If you want your model to be in 3D in GUI, play with sliders. Remember to check the option. Well, we've finished our 3D item. You can close the edit modes dialog and now we'll integrate the model in-game. Have a look at the model properties. Select item because what we do is an item. And name our model Iron Sword. Iron-Sword. Okay. The other parameters are not very interesting for the moment. Just click OK. Now, to export, click on File, Export, select JSON, and be sure to save your 3D model in the models/item folder in your resource pack. That's done. We've exported our first item made with Cubik. Now, I'll redo the exact same thing we've done, but in a time-lapse, by using the other sprites you've seen at the beginning of this tutorial. Okay, I've finished the second sword. Now I launch Minecraft and you'll be able to compare and say in the comments which one you prefer. This tutorial is now finished. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to ask questions on the Cubik Forum and like and sub on my channel. See you soon. Peace.